Our one-on-one just moments ago with Donald Trump. It's been a tumultuous 24 hours inside the Trump campaign, firing his campaign manager, new and disappointing fundraising numbers revealed, and tonight a new and blistering attack from Hillary Clinton. Tomorrow, Donald Trump will get his turn, but he's right here tonight. For the first time since the Clinton attack today, Trump now responding to her, to his fundraising numbers, to the national poll showing Clinton growing her lead. But he says, watch Ohio and Pennsylvania. Our sit-down came a short time after Clinton made the case, calling Trump's economic policies, quote, dangerous.
Just like he shouldn't have his finger on the button, he shouldn't have his hands on our economy.
Right afterward, we took those very words to Donald Trump, and here's what he told us. Hillary Clinton said of you just today that just like he shouldn't have his finger on the button, he shouldn't have his hands on our economy. Were you watching?
I was not watching. I heard what she said. I built a great, great company. It's worth tens. I mean, it's just a very, very valuable company. Some of the greatest assets in the world, including with what we're sitting on right here. She has a bad temperament. She would do so badly with the economy.
But you know their argument that President Obama inherited the Great Recession, that he created 14 million new private sector jobs in 6.5 years.
But we haven't come back. We have a dead economy. We are dead stagnant. We're losing our jobs to Mexico. We're losing our jobs to so many other places. I mean, you look at Mexico, what they're doing, it's unbelievable. It's like a modern day miracle where their companies, whether it's Carrier or Ford or so many other companies, just pouring into Mexico.
You know, you bring up Carrier, Ford, you've criticized Apple for taking jobs overseas. And Hillary Clinton said something today that we'll likely hear again from her in this general election, that the Trump ties are made in China, the Trump suits in Mexico, Trump furniture in Turkey, Trump barware in Slovenia.
It's true. And you know why? Because they devalue their currencies and they make it impossible for companies to compete. And she doesn't have to say that because I say it all the time. I say, unfortunately, my ties are made in China. And I will say this, the hats, Make America Great Again, I searched long and hard to find somebody that made the hats in this country.
But back to that point, when you criticize Carrier and Ford and Apple, you know what the Clinton camp is going to say. They're going to say, how do you criticize them when you're doing the same thing?
I openly say I do it, but you know what? Let them charge me a tax when the ties come back in. I mean, let them charge me a tax. I'd love to be able to not to do it. And the way we're not going to be able to do it, and the way people will stop doing it and stop moving, as an example, Carrier announced they're leaving 1,400 great people that have worked for them for many, many years, and they're moving to Mexico. But if we put a barrier from them, and we have to do it, we have no choice because we're losing all our companies.
What kind of barrier are you talking about? Because the argument is that will hurt the economy.
It's not going to hurt the economy. It's going to make America much richer.
There was something that she said today. She pointed to something that you have set out on the campaign trail, saying, I'm going to do for the country what I've done for business. But then she argued that you intentionally ran up huge amounts of debt, you bankrupted your companies not once but four times, and that hundreds of jobs were lost. How are you going to respond to Clinton, and were average Americans affected in any way by these bankruptcies?
Okay, so what I've done is I've used brilliantly the laws of the country, and not personally, just corporate. And if you look at people like myself that are at the highest levels of business, they've used, many of them have done it many, many times. They
But did any average Americans pay the price, though, for
that? No, but I'm running a business. You have to understand, I'm running a business. I'm running a business for myself, for my company, for my employees, and for my family. Hillary wouldn't have any idea how to do that. Don't forget, somebody has to understand debt. She doesn't understand debt.
We know this will be her argument this fall, that every major candidate in the last four decades has shown the American people their taxes. She says maybe you paid nothing or close to nothing. Maybe you're not as rich as you say you are. Maybe you haven't given away as much to charity. So I wanted to give you the opportunity to respond right now to Hillary Clinton. Will you reveal your taxes to the American people before the election?
As soon as the audit's done, I'm under a routine audit. I've been audited many, many years in a row. There are audits that go and they're routine. And by the way, you don't learn very much, if anything, from a tax return.
But they'll learn your tax
papers.
Rate.
No, but I filed papers with the federal elections. Now, when the audit's complete, 100%. I don't care. Now, a lot of people haven't filed their tax return. A lot of people haven't given their tax returns
what
prior
audit,
to a number
what
of
What if that audit is after Election Day? Is there a chance that your tax return will be?
I don't know if there will be. I hope it's not. But you know what? If it's before I give my tax returns, I have no problem with it.
There's a chance we
there
won't
would
see
be
them.
A chance, but I think it would probably be done before. It's very routine. But there would certainly be a chance.
And about this question over charity that she brings up on the campaign trail, do you want to reveal how much you paid to charity?
Well, I give a lot of money to charity. I would certainly tell you about it, but I'd have to come up with a number. I think I revealed over a period of years I've given over $100 million to charity. I think $102 million or something thereabouts to charity.
But you can come up with that number for us.
I think I would, yeah. I would have no problem with it.
Your former campaign manager, Corey Lewandowski, fired in the last 24 hours. He told us that he didn't see this coming. Your son, Don Jr., told me this morning that he was in the room for that firing. How big of a role do your children play in these decisions?
I really have them involved mostly with the business, and you know, they're people that have great respect for. They're my children. I have great respect for them.
But back to your son being in that room, Don Jr., that was pretty eye-opening for a lot of people, I think. And will there be a role for him, a role for Ivanka in a Trump White House?
Probably not. I would leave them to run the business. And I think that's what they really like doing, and that's what they're doing now.
We brought up Corey Lewandowski. He's now out. So you fired your campaign manager. Some pretty disappointing fundraising numbers for May.
Well, they're not really. I mean, I think there was only one day that was reported. And just so you understand, we've actually had some very good days, but they're not reported yet.
Let me just ask you, in the same time frame, though, you raised $3 million. Mitt Romney had raised $23 million in that time frame. John McCain, $20 million. And you're up against Hillary Clinton, who raised $25
million. Well, no, she's getting her money from the Wall Street guys and all the special interests. And I really don't, I'll be honest, you know, I've never raised money before for this because I've never done it before. I think I'd be very good at it. As far as I'm concerned, I'd be very happy to continue to self-fund. You know, I have...
Are you going to continue to self-fund?
I may.
How much?
Because to me, I think, I don't know, I can do whatever I want. She's going to spend $1.2 billion on an election. And I'm trying to say, where do you spend that money? Remember this. I spent $50 million and I won. Other people that were running against me spent many times that amount and they lost, not even close. I won in a landslide.
Will you spend another $50 million in the general or more?
I might. I really might decide to do that.
More of our one-on-one with Donald Trump on the way. He points to the very close polls in Pennsylvania and Ohio tonight. He also weighs in on Hillary Clinton's faith as we ask him what he would like to know about her and religion. And we ask, what would be off limits in going after Clinton in the general election now? That's later tonight on Nightline and tomorrow on GMA.